Hello, wizards, witches, and everyone in between. My name is Emma, and today I am here with my husband.
That's me.
And we are going to share with you the books that we got for Christmas. So, one of the books I got was Wilder Girls by Rory Power. And this was a gift from Cecilia from that Disney chick. I will link her channel down below. But all I know about this is that it's like a Lord of the Flies-esque thing with girls instead of boys. But I have never read Lord of the Flies. And I don't think you have to read this, but I really want to read it before I read this. But I'm really excited. I've heard mostly good things about it.
I got The Beginning of Everything by Robin Schneider. It's basically about this guy who is supposed to be homecoming king, and then his girlfriend cheats on him, and then he gets into an accident, and then it kind of flips his whole world around, which I can kind of relate to back in high school, so I'm hoping I enjoy it. I got this from my twin sister, so that's that.
I got Romanov. I received this as a gift from Avery, from Avery Loves Books, and I have been wanting to read this since I heard about it. It came out like really early this year, but I had tweeted that I was excited for it, and one person responded, and they said that I shouldn't be because they read an arc of it and it was awful, and for some reason, I believed them and never bought it for myself, which is stupid. Because there are a lot of people out there that like it, so I don't know why I listened to that one random person. But we have it now. I'm excited. The cover's gorgeous. And this is, like, obviously revolves around Anastasia. I think there's, like, a heist smuggling kind of thing going on. That's all I know. But I love a good, you know, take on the historical Anastasia thing. The animated movie was, like, my favorite as a kid. So I'm excited. Look how pretty that is.
It's pretty. I just think Romanov, I think Natasha.
Oh, yeah.
That's all I keep thinking about.
Yeah.
This is something I bought for myself. I bought a lot of Christmas books for gifts from me to me. this is The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime. So it's basically about this kid who doesn't really say, but I think he has, is it Asperger's? I mean, somebody who told me about it told me there is a dog who is found dead in their neighborhood, and he goes on a mission to sort of figure out how it died and whatnot. And I think I was reading some stuff on Goodreads that says that, like, some of the neighbors begin to blame him.
That's cool.
I'm stoked.
I've heard about that book for, like, my entire life, and I never actually knew what it was about.
Yeah, I mean, I've looked up a bunch of lists about, like, the books everyone should read, and this book has been on every single book list. Every single list, and your parents even told me about this. So, that's on there.
So I received Alex Approximately by Jen Bennett from Madison, from Madison Green. And I read Starry Eyes by Jen Bennett in like April, I think. And I really, really liked it. I usually don't like young adult contemporaries that often, like it's very rare. But I really, really liked Starry Eyes and I really liked her writing style. And so I wanted to read something else by her. So I'm really excited. I'd probably read this in the spring or summer, I guess. Look at the cover's very summery.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know anything about this. I know that the back cover of Starry Eyes like over explains things. And one of her other books does too, where it kind of spoils you for the plot. I don't know if this is one of the other ones, but I haven't read the back because I don't want to know. But I'm assuming it's like a cute contemporary with like some more substance to it than just that, which is what Starry Eyes had. It had a lot of like other themes and important things that were talked about, so yeah.
This is a book that I bought for myself, again, for me to me. It's called As Old as Time, and it's part of a series, the Twisted Tale series, where this one's basically What If Belle's Mother Cursed the Beast. And it kind of, I started reading it, I kind of paused myself because of the move and everything, but it kind of has, as far as I know, it's got this like weird vibe where it sort of starts off where the movie starts off, and then there's like a back and forth between future and past kind of thing. Like, it's going the same route as the movie is, but then you keep going back to the past, I think, to young Maurice and whatnot. And in the chapter I just got to, he just had a baby girl, so.
Oh, so it goes, like, way back.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I think you're supposed to introduce Belle's mom. Mm-hmm. But there's this whole thing that, I can't remember what they're called, but when Maurice was younger, in this book, there's this whole thing where, like, any enchanted creatures or witches or anything, people are beginning to be afraid of them. I've been on a really big, like, Disney binge, and I've been watching movies, and now I found this book, and I'm hoping if I like it, then I'll just keep reading all the twisted tales, because I keep seeing Conceal Don't Feel Anywhere.
Yeah, same.
And I'm like, it's okay if a 28-year-old man reads a book about two sisters. Because that one's supposed to be like, if Anna and Elsa never met, I think. I think they're still sisters, but they never met. But they have a bunch of these. And, I mean, so far, I got to page, like, 50, and I was enjoying it. So, yeah.
I also received Four Dead Queens by Astrid Schult from Krista. From Books with Krista, and this has been on my radar for a while now, and all I know about it is that I think it's kind of like a murder mystery situation where, like, some girl is trying to figure out who, like, killed these queens. That's all I know. But I know there's a couple people on BookTube where this is, like, one of their favorite reads of 2019, so I'm really excited to get to it. I'm excited for, like, a mystery kind of thrillery fantasy. One Big Lie, Two Forbidden Romances, 3 Days to Catch a Killer.
I got Imaginative Writing. It's basically just a book that that my father-in-law gave me for Christmas that is about the craft of writing. And it has a bunch of, like, stuff about plot and story building and narratives and whatnot. I am in the process of writing a novel, so I definitely am stoked to read this. I'll have you, like, review my novel when I read it, when I finish it. You can read it and then review it.
Am I gonna be the first person to read it?
Well, I'd be the first person to read it because I'm writing it, but yeah, okay. You'd be the first person to read it, I suppose.
Cool, thanks. Okay, so these next two I'm gonna group together because they are the same book, but this year I decided to collect, like, various editions of this book. And that is Wind in the Willows by Kenneth Graham. I got this one for my mother-in-law. It's the Barnes & Noble's classic edition. What?
No, it's just, he looks cute with his he little looks hand smug. In the water.
I have, like, a weird obsession with Mr. Toad. Mr. Toad's Wild Ride at Disneyland is, like, the best. And the animated little Disney thing is the best. Last summer, I think, I finally read Wind in the Willows from the library, and it really helped the Mr. Toad ride make a lot more sense. And I thought it was really cute, but also weird. But the scenes with Mr. Toad are definitely, like, the best. So I can see why the Disney movie just, like, pulled out all of the scenes and made a movie about him. But yeah, so I just have a weird obsession with this book and Mr. Toad. So this is my second copy now. And then he got me this gorgeous edition, which is, I believe, the Penguin Threads edition, where it looks like it's, like, sewn or embroidered onto the page, and I really, really like it. It was at the local used bookstore that we went to a lot when we lived in Sacramento, and then we moved, and I just figured I'd never grab myself a copy, but he bought it for me without my knowing, so good job.
That's me, yeah.
This book is kind of hard to explain what it's about. Supposedly a children's classic. It'd be a really boring book for children, I feel. It's about, like, this toad and this mole and this badger, and they kind of get wrapped up in a bunch of, like, legal issues. And the toad, Mr. Toad, he goes on this, like, adventure and gets himself wrapped up in a bunch of problems that his friends have to try and fix. And his estate, Toad Hall, is, like, losing money, and so it gets very, like, bogged down with, like, law stuff, which makes it a weird book for kids, but I liked it. Mr. Toad's the shit, so eventually I'll just have a whole Wind in the Willows shelf.
Yeah.
I just need a little Mr. Toad, like, something.
Yeah, with the Pop Doll wasn't.
Yeah, the Pop Doll for, like, Mr. $800. Toad is, like, legit $800, and I'm like, I guess because they didn't make that many copies of him, because no one cares except me.
The next book I got was from my mother. It's The Odyssey, the illustrated Barnes & Noble's copy by Homer. And this is one of those books that I have been wanting to read since I was like in the
same
middle school, or she got it for me, of like an illustrated Odyssey and whatnot with a bunch of like illustrations, I guess. I mean, that makes sense. Yeah, I mean, I don't know if I have to explain what it's about. I feel like everybody knows the story.
Yeah. So my friend Audrey, who's been in several videos on my channel, she got me Queen Meryl by Erin Carlson. And I remember it came out this year, and I remember I saw it at Barnes & Noble, and I was like, Meryl Streep, that's legit. And then I completely forgot this book existed. So I was very surprised when she gave it to me for Christmas. We have a Mamma Mia obsession, and so Meryl Streep is kind of like an inside jokey thing with us, even though like we actually do really, really like love her. But it makes sense that she's the one who gave this to me, is what I'm saying. But yeah, Meryl Streep, like, I've been obsessed with her for years and years and years. And this is supposed to be really well written and like insightful, and talk about like, I think every movie she's done, and like give like trivia stuff about it and all kinds of stuff. So I'm excited. And this cover is gorgeous. It's one of those hardbacks that doesn't have a stupid dust jacket, so props to them for that.
Another book that I got that I guess is considered a Christmas present to myself, even though I got it today on the 26th, is Bearskin. This book I got, I was walking around Barnes & Noble today with my mom, and we're going to the cabin this weekend, and I really felt like it was a very like nice cabin-y book to read. It's about this guy named Rice Moore, and he moved to Virginia from Arizona, and in Arizona he got into trouble with some like drug cartels people that he turned in, or he betrayed, I guess. And so he moved to Virginia to escape basically his past, and he has a job as a cabin rebuilder. Yeah, he like fixes and rebuilds cabins in Virginia. One day he's walking in the woods and he finds a bear carcass. So he makes it his mission to find out who's the poachers, who's poaching these bears before, you know, more bears go, you know, get killed or whatever. Like, his past begins to come back and haunt him. And he gets in trouble with like his bosses, his landlords, and even the community and whatnot. So yeah, that's Bearskin. This one is one I'm really excited to start reading.
My butt's literally only half on this thing. So my parents got me If Only by Melanie Murphy. Melanie Murphy is a really famous YouTuber. She's been around forever. And she wrote kind of like a memoir thing a couple years ago, which I still haven't read. But this is her first fiction novel, and I've kind of been following along with her, you know, making videos about writing this and how she got the idea for it and what it's about and how it relates to certain aspects of her own life. And I'm just really excited to read it because I feel like I've kind of been there along the process. It sounds really cool. The main character is 30 and she travels to visit her grandmother. I believe this takes place in Ireland. There's a lot of things happening in the main character's personal life with like relationships, and she's kind of trying to figure out who she is. And there's this big like what if thing with this locket. And that's all I'm gonna say. Yeah, I couldn't find it anywhere forever. I think it was like only published in the UK for a while. So I'm glad I finally got a copy, and the font is ginormous, so it should be a pretty quick read. I'm excited.
Yeah,
it's cool. One of the few like non-young adult ones I got for Christmas.
So my last book is Sold on a Monday by Christina McMorris. It's based on a true story, so this is an actual sign that somebody took a picture of that said two children for sale. It's about this photographer, I think, who snaps a photo of this sign, and it becomes like his big break, and he starts to struggle with whether or not how far he wants to go with this story, because I guess it starts to affect his life. Then there's another character called Lillian. She works for the same paper that he does, and this story about the two children for sale start to kind of like bring back memories about her childhood and the way that she was raised and whatnot. It says a masterpiece, both heartfelt and heartbreaking.
Sounds sad.
Yeah, I'm excited. Little sad boy with his little briefcase.
So the last book I got for Christmas is the illustrated Harry Potter and the what?
Goblet of Fire you got for Christmas.
Oh, snap. Wow. I've already talked about it a lot in videos, though.
Wow. Okay, that's fine.
My husband got me the Goblet of Fire illustrated one when it first came out as like an early Christmas present, but I've already talked about that a lot in videos, so I won't talk about it here. But so I was missing the third one, which is annoying because the third one is definitely one of my favorite books in the series. My boy Lupin shows up in this one, so you know it's going to be a good time. I'm really excited to be able to read this and then Goblet of Fire in these illustrated editions because I've really, really slowly been rereading the series. And we just finished the audiobook for Chamber of Secrets, so I'm definitely going to, oh my god. I'm definitely going to read these illustrated editions for 3 and 4 for sure. A little sneak peek, that's Aunt Marge, and she looks completely terrifying. So, look at her feet. I really hate that.
I hate how like her like face got really big. But her eyes are like causing stretch marks on the side of her face.
Yeah, that's honestly terrifying. Yeah. I hate that. But yeah, so that's the last book I got. I'm really excited to read it. All right, you guys, I hope you enjoyed this book haul. Thank you to everyone who sent me books.
I was just pointing at Yoda. Oh. It's my boy.
Thank you to everyone who sent me books from my Amazon wish list. You guys did not have to do that, but that was so sweet. Yeah, let me know down below if you've read any of the books we talked about. Is there anything you want to say?
No. Just, again, I mean, thanks for sending my wife books. Mm-hmm. It felt really cool to get a package, and no, it wasn't for me, so.
Wow. Okay. Someone's salty. Okay, well, I hope
but I also read, oh, sorry.
What?
I just feel like I also read, maybe I don't, like fantasy more than you do?
I don't know.
No?
It's probably about the same. You just read, like, adult fantasy.
True. Yeah, you should see my Game of Thrones shelf. It's been blowing up.
Mm-hmm. What? You're looking at me all sideways. Yeah, okay. That's it. I hope you guys are doing well, and I will see you next time.
Bye!